Get ready.
Hey friends, and welcome back to another Disney Plus video. So today, I decided let's have a little look at the Marvel subsection. We did the Disney, Pixar, and Star Wars subsections previously, so let's have a look into the Marvel subsection. It's going to be quite a lot, so let's have a little look here. Just to let you guys know, we are doing this video in advance, so some things might change with how they look, but this is, again, just an overview of what it looks like. So let's click on Marvel here. And I'll go in there. I do like that little animation there. It's good to see some of these things that have appeared. And just so you know, we do have Loki Season 2 coming out in October. October 6th, I think, is the exact day. It's whatever the first Wednesday is in October there. So really looking forward to that series to see how they're going to make this multiverse work now. So because it's wide open there, we all know. We can look at the Spider-Man movie, the Loki Season 1, and blah, 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 blah. And the introduction of, like, the X-Men and stuff like that. I can't wait. I really hope we get a bit of a hint into the X-Men, because X-Men 97 is almost out there. They've got new merch and stuff out there. But anyways, Disney Plus, let's have a look. So, featured, we've got Secret Invasion. Now, check out my review of that. In the finale review, I do an oversight of the whole series of that. In a nutshell, it's pretty good. It's a good story. It's a precursor, I think, to what's going to go on here with this guy. But yeah, hey ho. Cloak and Dagger, I've never seen it, so I really am looking forward to watching that. And you got the documentary of Stan Lee, which came out on his birthday, I believe. Assembled the making of Quantum Mania. Spidey and Amazing Friends, The Incredible Hulk, that came on the other week as a surprise drop. Really enjoyed that. So all we need now is to get the Spider-Man movies on here, and then we've got everything for the MCU. Got Legends, Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania. Disney have made it known that they're not going to recast Kang as well, just to let you guys know. Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. Falcon and the Winter Soldier, which you really need to watch before seeing the new Captain America movie. And you got Deadpool, Black Panther, Ant-Man, and then Ant-Man and the Wasp. Character collection. So this is good. This is something that's different from all the other subsections on Disney Plus. Is you've got this, and it'll link then into the different subsections and sort of different collections, which is really good. I think so. I think we should have more of these in the other subsections. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments whether you think the other subsections should have things like this. So say, like with Star Wars, it'll be like the Han Solo collection, or the Clone Wars collection, and things like that. Let me know. So you got Ant-Man collection, Black Panther collection, Hulk collection, Thor collection, Doctor Strange collection, Black Widow collection, Falcon and the Winter Soldier collection. They're not important enough to have a separate one. Hawkeye collection, Loki collection, Wanda and Vision collection, and the Spider-Man collection. Okay. So you got the MCU Infinity Saga. So this will be all in timeline order. No, sorry, release order for the movies, pretty much. So that's really cool. I corrected myself because Captain America would have been the first one on there. So that's really cool. So that's everything then, apart from the Spider-Man movies, for the Infinity Saga. Because it did include what is it? There you go, Incredible Hulk as well. And then you got MCU Multiverse Saga. So we are in the new phase and things. So things have started changing, all thanks to this man here. So you got WandaVision, Falcon and Winter Soldier, Loki, Black Widow, even though Black Widow is technically Infinity Saga. But then some bits of it is included in the Multiverse Saga. It's messy. What If, you got Shang-Chi, Eternals, Hawkeye, Moon Knight, Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, Ms. Marvel, Thor, Love and Thunder. Then you got the I Am Groot shorts. She-Hulk, Werewolf by Night, which is nothing really to do with the MCU. Just to let you guys know, so it's nothing to do with the Multiverse Saga. Unless it is saying it's a different universe, blah, blah, blah. Which, It's understandable, really. Then you go Wakanda Forever, the Guardians of the Galaxy Holiday Special, which I recommend watching before watching Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. They will have Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 on here, but I'm recording this before it comes out. So make sure to click that subscribe button and watch our What's on Disney Plus videos. Last week, we released our What's on Disney Plus in September video. Make sure to keep up to date with all of those. Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania, and Secret Invasion. Then Marvel Original Stories. Okay, that's... what? Oh, sorry. Marvel Origin Stories. I read that wrong. I'm sorry. So these are the origin stories for some of these characters here. I think the Incredible Hulk is the origin story. I think they briefly... say about it on there, but here we go. You got Marvel Animation, so you got What If, you got X-Men, and I cannot wait for X-Men 97. The I Am Groot ones, Rise of Technovore. Okay, happy days. What else we got then? We got some Spider-Man cartoons here, and the Spectacular Spider-Man, Spider-Woman, Spider-Man. All right. Iron Man, Fantastic Four, Spider-Man that I used to watch, Incredible Hulk, Silver Surfer, Spider-Man Unlimited. Here we go. So we've got lots and lots of different animations for you to watch here. I've barely seen any of these, to be honest. Maybe I should. Maybe I should. And Battleworld Mystery of the Thanos Stones. My brother actually worked on that. Funny enough, there you go. So Marvel Unscripted. So Unscripted is like factual programs. So that's all of the Empower. Ooh, what's this? What is this all about then? Ooh, this is pretty cool. Each episode of Empower reveals the history and untold stories of the most iconic women in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. The women behind the Guardians of the Galaxy, Wakanda, Captain Marvel, and Scarlet Witch share their triumphs and are joined by adoring fans whose lives were touched by the stories of their heroes. Now, I do actually remember this coming out, but it's just interesting to see. So you got lots of different things there, a lot of behind the scenes things and documentaries about Marvel on here. Be interesting if we get there was a game show where Stan Lee had some cosplayers and character creators to think of a different hero, and they like had like different missions that to do. It's quite cool. So timeline order. So this is now everything in timeline order, not release order. I do recommend changing some of these as well. So Ant-Man and the Wasp, I would watch in between Infinity War and Endgame. But it's not really needed, to be honest, to do that. But that's how I would to watch it, to be honest. So you got all those there. We don't have any of the Spider-Man movies on here anymore. It looks like they've removed them all. You got one shots. They're quite funny. IMAX enhanced movies. So that's pretty cool. We are going to go through the IMAX enhanced movies in another episode. So I'm not going to go through those right now. And then you got the Defenders. So these are the Netflix series that came out, which is pretty cool. Or you've also got the Daredevil movie, Elektra movie, and then one of the Punisher movies as well. Mutant Legacy, so everything to do with mutants. So you got X-Men, Deadpool, X-Men First Class, The Gifted, X-Men Origins, Wolverine, Legion, X2, X-Men The Last Stand, The New Mutants, X-Men The Series, Logan, X-Men Days of Future Past, X-Men Apocalypse, The Wolverine, Deadpool 2, and then X-Men Dark Phoenix. Then you do have the Spider-Verse. Now, this is interesting that they've decided to put the Spider-Verse in, considering that we did have a lot of the Spider-Man movies on Disney Plus UK, and then they took them from us. It's like, no, why did you do that? But it's all down to licensing and things, guys, because remember now, Disney do not own the rights to Spider-Man, okay? So that's why there's a lot of red tape and things like that. So it costs Disney to put the Spider-Man movies on Disney Plus and stuff like that. So it's like, just be mindful with that. So you got everything that's Spider-Man is being in, or the cartoons that are on Disney Plus. There you go. So literally not one Spider-Man movie anymore. That's quite sad. So we've got Agents and Inhumans. So I did not like the Inhumans series, but it was good to see that Black Bolt was in Multiverse of Madness. Oh, you got Ghost Rider on there. Brilliant. He's not a mutant. That's quite interesting. Fantastic Adventures, so everything to do with Fantastic Four. So they've got those two movies and that movie there. And there will be another one coming out soon. Oh, look at that. So we got even more collections. That's pretty cool. So we've got Guardians of the Galaxy collection, Avengers collection, Marvel Rising collection, X-Men collection, Infinity Saga collection, Marvel Animation collection, and the One-Shot collection. So I'm guessing once the Multiverse Saga has finished, they'll make a Multiverse Saga collection, unless they will sort that out sooner rather than later. But there we go, guys. That is the Marvel section there. Are you liking the new way that Marvel are going in this direction or not? Let me know in the comments. Also, are you excited about X-Men 97? Are you excited about Loki Season 2? And what other things are you excited about Marvel? Let me know in the comments. But thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to join our membership for more content and to really support us, as well as checking out our social medias and our gaming channel, which is Skybot Gaming, as you can see on the top there. But thanks very much for watching, guys. But until next time, bye.